Welcome to How It Works. I'm Bob Ambrogi, and this is the show where we learn about legal tech products directly from their developers. In today's episode, we're going to be taking a look at Link App by Mobile Helix, an application that allows lawyers to be more productive on their mobile devices. Here today to tell us all about it and show us how it works is Seth Hallem, the co-founder and CEO. Seth, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Bob. Glad to be here.
Before we get into the demo, why don't you tell us a little bit about Link App and Mobile Helix?
Sure. Well, the easiest way to understand what we're all about at Mobile Helix is to look back in time a little bit. So before I started this company, I was in an entirely different industry building software tools for engineers. And around about my fifth year of being in that company, we started to get handheld devices. And it was a whole new world for us. First, it was the Handspring Trio. And then we got our Blackberries. And suddenly we felt so immensely productive. So after I left that industry and with the invention of the iPad and the iPhone, but the iPhone was maturing by the time we got into Mobile Helix, the iPad was a new thing. We started to think, how do you get that BlackBerry-like shot of productivity out of these new devices from Apple and then soon to follow the Android devices that were enterprise ready? And we started looking at all the various concerns you might have about security, about privacy, about data access, data control. And then we started thinking about workflows and how do you actually get anything done on this device? And particularly, how do you go well beyond email? BlackBerry was a fantastic email device. BlackBerry's downfall was that it was only a fantastic email device. And so that's how we came to Link and the Link app. Our goal is to provide a secure way for lawyers to work. It's really as simple as that. And over time, everything that that means for lawyers will put into our app. At least that's our goal. And because they're doing that work on an iPad or an iPhone, it comes with you everywhere you go and has all the advantages of the device you love.
The Handspring, you're going to get me nostalgic thinking about that.
Yeah. But,
fortunately, we moved on from there.
Yes. Yes.
Well, good. Why don't we dive in and you can show us how it works.
Okay. Well, because this is a mobile app, I'm going to start by sharing my iPad here. So the first thing that I want to start our demo with here is our email inbox. Email feels like a throwback to the BlackBerry. But that said, I think we can all agree that lawyers today still use email. In fact, they still live in email. And while Teams might make a run at your time, it's still email that wins out in the end. And a very common thing that would happen in your email is you receive a contract or a document that has been sent out and now revised or reviewed at least by a counterparty. That could be your client or it could be another law firm that you're working with on a particular transaction. So let's imagine that I've sent out a certificate of incorporation and now I've received that back. And here's where we start getting into the power of Link. The first thing that we've done in Link that's unique is we've brought your email and your document management system into one place. And that means many things, and I won't have time to show all of them. We have a wealth of videos available from our website, so you can see everything you can do in Link from there. But let's start with a very basic thing, which is I receive an attachment. Now I want to open it. First thing I can see here is that I'm now looking at my email and my document side by side, so whatever feedback this particular counterparty has sent in that email, I can take a look at the document, and I can see the same thing. The next thing I want to do is file this to DMS. So we have an upload button at the bottom right. I can see the various places where I can upload. In this case, I'll put it straight into iManage. And this is a document I've been working on recently, so I'm just going to upload it as a new version of that same document. So with just a moment's effort, now I've got my file in DMS. And we'll take a look at DMS where I can confirm exactly what I've just done here. So you can see that I've got that document, same exact document right here. Now I want to see what exactly was changed. And so we've brought versioning and redlines into our iManage client that's built into the Link app. I'll compare the version that I received against the one that I sent. And now here's the first place where I'm getting to something interesting. I'm able to look at the exact redline of what I've received in email from the counterparty against the version that I sent them maybe a few days ago. And I can see that they've deleted a substantial part of the document. Now that we've covered DMS and email in one app and at least one specific instance of why that's a good idea, let's talk about what you can do now that you have this document in front of you, you've got this redline comparison to look at, and you'd like to move the workflow forward, either with your own client or maybe with other lawyers in your firm. So a common thing I might want to do is look at this document and make a markup indicating my thoughts about exactly what this change has been. And so we've built full PDF annotation into the link app so that you can do that without having to move the document to another app, risk any kind of data loss as you move it to insecure locations, and also without the hassle of moving documents between apps. So I'll go ahead and annotate that PDF here in link. And here's the change, and I'm going to make a comment on that change. So I drop my comment right in here, and I'll note that other side says their client is not going to operate in California. Because it turns out that this section that I've deleted has to do with considerations for corporations with California shareholders and operations. Now that I've done taking this note, I again have options for how to keep my workflow moving. And this is a lot of what we've tried to achieve in Link. We try to think of it as no dead ends. Once I've done something, I never get to the point where I say, now I'm stuck. Instead, I can decide what to do. So if I just look at the bottom right, I can see some options here. Now that I've made my revision to my document, one thing that I might want to do is save that revision back to iManage so that my colleagues can see it in iManage. So again, I have the upload button at the bottom right. I'll just tap upload, and I'll go ahead and upload this back into Work 10. And we're defaulting to the workspace where this document is stored. So I'll put it into my attorney notes folder, save here, and now I've uploaded my notes so that I can share it with my colleagues. Last thing I might want to do is email those notes to somebody else. And so let's say I decide I'm going to email them to Maureen, my colleague. I have a nice attachments overlay. And while I won't go through all the details, you can see here that you can attach documents from your DMS, like NetDocuments, from OneDrive, from other sources. And I could send along that document directly from the Link app. Now that I'm done making my markups, a very common thing that I might want to do is make an edit. I've decided that there's something wrong with that particular change, or I need to add something to the document. And so for this, we'll go back to the DMS application here, back into iManage. I'll find my document here with just a quick filter for the document. And you can see here that there's a pencil button right next to the document, which I'm going to tap to start editing it. This is checking out the document, opening in the Office app for iOS. So we're using the native Microsoft technology, and we have all possible ways of securing that connection with everything from Microsoft Purview encryption to Microsoft's application management built on top of Intune to just standard MDM. And now that it's in the Word app, the Office app in this case, I can go ahead and make a change. So the deleted part was right here, and I can say a note that client needs to confirm no presence in California. Now that I'm done with my edit, I can return to the Link app. And now I'm prompted to check that change back into iManage. So I don't have to remember to do it. It's right in my face, a reminder to get that done. So I just tap to do so. I'm going to upload a new version. And I go ahead and confirm that upload. And now I've made a small edit. I've checked it back into DMS. And as we already saw, I could have gone ahead and emailed that document. The last thing I want to do is show you what happens when I decide that it's time to save that email. I'm going to close out a few tabs here to get organized. Slide this back into full screen mode. And now I want to close out my workflow. I'm done with this. It's time to file this email back to DMS. And here's again an advantage of having DMS and email in a single app. I can either swipe here and I have the file button over to the right, or I have a file button at the top right just next to the settings button. And if I pull up the filing destinations, you can see here that I have once again my different options for where to file. I can file it to DMS. I could file it into my Outlook folders. I could file it to other destinations that my IT organization might approve. And this is an important place to make the point that while I'm listing OneDrive and a Windows file share here, these are options. Options available to IT organizations to make their own decisions about what they wish to include in this overlay. I won't go through the filing action here, but the more times you file an email from a certain group of senders or a certain subject or a certain thread, the more Link is going to learn. And so soon you'll have a list of populated recommendations, and we're always showing your recent filing destinations. So over time, you have a much more complete picture of exactly where you're used to filing a certain thread or certain emails, and it just becomes faster and faster the more you use it. Another nice feature in Link is that if you want to file multiple emails, you can just toggle on 3 or 4 of these emails and then swipe and file all 3 of them. And so it's very easy to clean up your inbox in Link and drop things straight into DMS that way.
Are those swipe actions configurable?
They absolutely are. So we have extensive settings here in email. You can go ahead and choose what your first left, second left, third left, and then right swipes as well. So you have quite a lot of options here, both for customizing the look, the font size, your swipe actions, and for example, what happens when you file an email to DMS? Is it automatically removed from your inbox? Is it left behind? So quite a lot of ways to personalize the app to the way that you work. And of course, we allow our administrators to set defaults so they can always match what you're used to at your desktop as much as possible.
Seth, I'm curious, obviously you're showing this on your iPad. What's the user experience like on a smaller screen if I'm on my iPhone, say?
Sure. And the best way to tell you is just to show you. So if you look here, essentially, this split view that we have where we have your inbox on the left and the current message on the right, that just gets collapsed down into a single column. And it's a similar idea with all the other applications that we have in Link, our DMS applications, our file browsing applications. Where we have the space, we make it larger. Where we don't, we make it smaller. But what's really important is that we have the same exact set of features across both platforms, and we always try to keep that perfectly consistent. I should mention before we wrap up that there's a lot of other features in Link that I haven't covered. We allow you to mobilize your intranet. We allow you to take notes and have those notes synchronize automatically back to iManage. We support iManage, NetDocuments. We allow you to mobilize file shares. And all of this, this entire screen, is in administrator control and something that you can vary based on roles within an organization.
I did want to ask, you mentioned NetDocuments, iManage. What other applications, what are the applications that can be integrated with this application?
So on the back end, we support right now 5 different file systems. The DMS apps are NetDocs, iManage, and then we also support eDocs. And then the more regular kind of file and folder file systems we support are OneDrive and Windows file shares. We support our, obviously an integration with Exchange, and that can be on-premise or online. Similar for iManage, that can be on-premise or online. And then more generally, we integrate with anything that's on your intranet. And so we have kind of a broader intranet integration that allows you to just link to any URL that might not be publicly accessible and create a nice tile for it. And then users can get to internal websites that they wouldn't have been able to get to otherwise.
What about logins and passwords? How do you handle that?
So that's a very good question and something we actually spent quite a lot of time working on over the last few years. We started with a very basic Active Directory integration. You log in with what you would consider to be your work password. But obviously the world of sign-in has moved quite a lot. And so now we support many different modes of authentication. We support a native Microsoft authentication where we're essentially using Microsoft Authenticator and the native Microsoft stack for authenticating. And if you are an Azure Entra ID shop and that's the way you sign in, that's perfect for you. We also support a more broad single sign-on integration that uses Apple's native infrastructure and Android's native infrastructure for single sign-on. And that's really for any sign-on provider like Okta or Duo or any of the others. You can use that integration and have a nice single sign-on experience. So generally what we try to do is mirror the modern authentication regime that our customers have chosen. If they're a Microsoft shop, we go that direction. If they're more of an Okta or a Duo shop, we just go with the standard kind of SSO package that works across all the different devices that we support.
You just mentioned Android there. Do you support Android as well?
We do. So the Android experience is very similar. We support Android tablets. We support Android phones. And in both cases, we have 2 variants of our app. We have the standard Link app, and then we have the Link for Intune app. And that's true on iOS, and it's also true on Android.
Well, I hear you that there's a lot more to show here. Anything else you'd like to show us today? Or we'll certainly put a link in the notes for this episode to your full library of videos on the product. Anything else you want to cover today?
I think that's a good place to wrap up for today. I'd love for our interested viewers to go to our website. We have such a wealth of videos. It's a great opportunity to see everything that Link can do. And of course, you can also call us for a live demo.
Seth, thanks so much for joining us today. It's been good to see you and great to hear about this.
Thank you for having me.
That's it for this episode of How It Works. I'm Bob Ambrogi. You can find the full series at directory.lawnext.com under the Resources tab, or find us on YouTube. Just search for How It Works there. Thanks for watching.